Hello again, folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Pathfinder Wrath of the Righteous. I'm your Dungeon Master, Darius. Hello again, Bird. Last we left off, we had finally managed to reach Tirabaid Estates. And it's quite a lovely little three-story house that happens to be the current feeding grounds, I guess, for lack of a better word, of a succubus. That's not good. So what we'll end up doing is we're going to go inside. Aaron's going to bless. Someone is going to throw sleep. Hopefully I can get Ember to get the vulnerability curse on the succubus or evil eye of some sort. I'm not sure which I should do the most. Probably AC so that the three melee people can actually, you know, hit her. This is far more planning than I've ever done in Baldur's Gate, I swear. But we're gonna drop a quick save here for ease. So bless. You're going to bless weapon yourself. If I could make it so as you could make yourself unaffected by her charms, I would. But I suppose for the moment, you're fine. And mage armor yourself.
Oh, yes, what?
Mage armor yourself. Yes. Alright, with all those cast, we'll quick save again. Because hell with it. We can throw a grease in there to put a damper in the plans. We want to kill the fighter or disable him as soon as we can, because he's effectively able to do like 20 plus damage every single hit. And from a plus 7 strength, that is stupid when you consider he's doing that with a rapier. So
I crave your commands.
Together we stand.
It's 1 minute per level, so you're good with that. So, what we can do is I can throw a sleep in there. Or not, apparently. Right.
This is my kind of work.
Why did that not even target anyone? I know that you're typically unable to target people you can't see, but... Damn it. And damn it. Is it even worth trying to get in there to do the killing? I don't know. And you can't charge up to him because out of reach. Only thing she can do is move there. Okay. Good chunk to his HP. If I can get... Nope, you are... Right, there we go. Excuse you? That's fine. We'll just blinding raid this guy. Did that hit? That apparently did. With a crit. Okay. But he's dazzled though, so hopefully he doesn't do anything. Uljif, stay here. Ember, can you at least get a sight on the succubi? Oh no, she's invisible, isn't she? I think she might be invisible at the moment. Charge that guy. God damn it, I hate the damage that you do, sir. And you... Oh, never mind. What the hell was charged for you? Keep on trying to do that with you. And just out of range. Alright, in which case... just move on up. And if anyone tries to cast a spell or get past you, just whack them, please. I know you could have done better. She's in there somewhere. There you are. Hi. Oh, concealment. Yeah, that would do it. You frequently miss the enemy succubus. There are many spells and abilities that your armor won't protect against you against. The only way I'm going to be able to damage her is with a critical or via touch attacks, huh? Consider the following. Evil Eye. Ah, come on. I effectively have a 25% chance to even affect her. Alright. Please. You're about to die. Alright. Activate Keen. Sacred Weapon. Please work. Oh, she's got... Wait.
Let's try this way.
Oh, right. It's only affecting her for a round. Heck. So, for those that don't know,
this will hurt.
She's apparently also affected by Blur, which is granting her concealment. I don't know where the blur is on her, but it is. How is she affected by blur? She really needs to stop making those sounds. Freaking 50% chance of freaking missing her. Is this even possible right now? I can slap her with this, but it would do nothing. I can basically magic missile the dork in the back. DC 20? He has to roll a freaking natural 20 in order for me to even... Difficulty class, 21. What the hell is your saving throw, sir? I can't even see it because he's a goddamn idiot. Alright. Vulnerability curse, then. Oh my god, she failed it. You have no resistances anymore. I beg of you. I beg of you. Freaking hit him.
I'll just sit here. Don't worry about me.
I fucking hate this game right now. What's that? Bless? Yeah, that'd be a great effect, wouldn't it? So powerful. Okay. I know the laws of probability say that 50-50 is a perfectly even chance of hitting or missing something. But consider what we've been witnessing right now. Are you even affected by sleep? Yeah, nothing saying you're immune to it. Yep. The hell else can I even do to you? It's a standard action to cast this, so... Only thing I can really do is swing and hope. And of course, the one time that the concealment didn't screw me over, a nat one did. Continues to fail a saving throw, that's a good thing, I guess.
A calculated risk.
Not even a calculated risk, just freaking laws of probability are ever against me right now. The one time you decide to make the actual saving throw. Oh. Okay. No longer has concealment on. I'm basically half dead. The only real thing I think I could do, theoretically even, is do some healing on myself. If I try to cast it as a spell, though, I'm going to get hit. I'm going to get slapped and pain will happen. Oh, wait. Against mind-affecting effects that rely on negative emotions or harm an ally. So really, I should cast this on most of the party. Yeah, if I cast anything right at this exact moment, I'm gonna get slapped in the face. So, is the blur effect gone or not? Make up your mind. A reminder that 50% shouldn't be this bad. I don't care what game you're playing. I don't care if you're playing as XCOM. I am going to lose my mind trying to fight this bitch. Please. I'm not even certain what else I can do against her. Blind her with Ray. Oh boy. It is quite literally the laws of probability right now that are screwing me over.
Pretty good, aren't I?
Alright. I'm not exactly certain how the hell the chain of these events are going to happen, but they will happen themselves. I could probably affected by spell resistance. One of the biggest cruxes I absolutely hate about 3.5 in Pathfinder is their incessant desire to have everything affected by spell resistance. Like, I get it. I understand the mechanic. I also just hate the mechanic. Okay. Firebelly, Haze of Dreams, Protection from Good, Protection from Evil. I have way too many spell scrolls, and no, I am not ever going to remember any of their freaking effects. Scroll of Faith, Scroll of... You know, once I do get the Vulnerability Curse Honor, then pretty much one of your best options is the Snowball spell. Guess copy some spell books. Okay. Second verse, same as the first, I guess. Yeah, she's invisible right now. Wait, overcame it. Does that mean she's asleep, or does that mean I don't get to see the thing? How dare you, game? Yes! Is immune to the condition per- Okay. Don't know why the hell a succubus is immune to getting prone, but guess I'll take my win somewhere. Alright, move right up here. We've already blessed. We are going to cast for 1 minute. Make it so as you have Axiomatic Strike. There you are, bitch. You are not flat-footed. Blindness. Made the save. Managed to overcome the spell resistance, but the save, on the other hand, that was another question entirely. But she does not seem to have... does not seem to have her capability of... Blur. Succeeded the throw. Just means that I need to have everyone focus on her. Someone hit her. Holy crap. Touch spells. When did the concealment happen? Alright. Right in her face, smite. Or you can whiff. You can whiff gloriously. I need to have Sacred Weapon on. Swap it to Keen.
Let's try this way.
Okay.
I saw them.
Please tell me that did not just hit Windowog. One character that was almost 100% able to smack her. And you had to do it to Windowog. Damn it. Windowog, go to sleep. You're less of a threat on the ground right now. Frick me. Now I basically have to try to kill the entranced fighter, otherwise Cella's dead again.
The Inheritor, guide my blade!
God, I wish we had multiple attacks already. Okay, reminder. Keen happens on a 19 to 20. Doesn't even mean I need to hit her or something. I just need to be able to get in there. I just need one bewildering injury on her. Wait. That worked! She's dazed! Okay. She's dazed. Please take care of the fighter. Good. I need to hit her. Because I don't want to waste this opportunity here. So she's dazed, which means she should be flat-footed.
The light, take you!
End me. How long does Mighty Evil supposed to last? It's supposed to last until the succubus falls. Please hit. Okay.
Cover me, all right?
How could this happen to me? I've made some mistakes. That's gonna be useless against her. What am I doing? Okay. I keep on doing that. I don't know exactly what it is I'm doing here. More hit dice than your wizard level, dazed for one round per level. Dazzled. Gotta love that distinction. Dazzled or dazed? This is not the time to notice a trap, but okay. Alright, move here. Okay. Seriously, where did the concealment come from? God damn it. Yes, thank you. I know about touch AC. It's also just one of the worst things I can possibly try to do against her right now. Thank you. Alright, she is taking damage. That's a plus. She is dazzled. I forget what dazzled does. Minus one on attack rolls and sight perception checks. Don't know why I thought the thing called Blinding Ray was actually going to cause blinding effects. She's effectively useless against her. Oh, stop your laughing. I could... Full strength on Aaron. Chug a potion. Miss. Okay. That was a good use, though. That was a good use of Bull's strength, because now I can hit on an 18. How long is your concealment?
Surrender, or else!
Where is your concealment? Aaron will, Divine of Magic. Wait, is it some sort of demon of magic bullshit? Immune to trip, extra planar subtype. Sounds you make disturb me, woman. This is literally a battle of attrition right now. Oh, you're awake. Oh, you're awake. All right, stand up. You got a bitch to hit.
I'll rip you apart.
I'm hoping that Dominate was only once, like, ever on a particular day. All right. Lay on hand self. Keep that. I love lay on hands. Such a useful effect. We are starting to run out of patience. So, 50% chances, huh? Is there any scrolls that you can use? Can be, well, okay, there are, but most of them are with attempts at, well, no, what am I doing?
Someone else would make better use of this.
No, you would make the best use of it right now. It's just that you can't. All right, 1 minute per level within close range. Fortitude saving throw. Are you even affected by sicken? Doesn't say you're not. Or, you know, same verse, all that fun shit. She's immune to magic missile, so I'm just gonna. The one character that made it past the goddamn.
Into the fray!
Please, someone. Anyone. It's like force, bless, that mage armor shit. She's still dazzled, so she's still getting that negative one. I feel like this is the most literal battle of attrition I've ever had. I need to hit on a 50-50 chance because of her concealment. But then, after the 50-50 chance, some of the characters have a 20% chance to hit, while other characters have literally a 5% chance to hit. A natural 20 on the die. And then I still have to get through her concealment if I try to use a touch spell. Which, by the way, as you can see, didn't exactly help. Alright, she's no longer affected by the...
Stab you or zap you? Why not both?
50%! This is officially pissing me off. I clicked evil eye, but okay.
They'll beg me to stop!
Am I forgetting something here? Is there... I don't have dispel magic. I don't have a bunch of things. All I can do is kind of just point shit at her and hope. And of course, hope that that... Oh my god, come on. Why must you tease me like that? Okay, I got an idea for Ninio's next turn, but it's not a very good idea. I can touch with this. Mana damage... 1d6 plus 1d6 for every 3 priest levels. It's gonna do next to nothing. What spells do we even have? Those are useless. Your mod. Bone Shaker. Okay. I gotta bypass her spell resistance. Which actually, let's take a 5-foot step back really quick. Yep. Par for the course, par for the course, par for the course, par for the course. Alright, she succeeded the throw, which means that she should have lost her resistance still. So why not? Let's waste some snowballs. Actually, No. Do I have any more bull strength? I have only got bear's endurance. Actually, wait. Okay, for one wrong character's turn. Probably could try to Bane. One creature within touch range. Within touch. My thing is, I don't want to try to get her through. I don't want to try to get her to go through its space. Because if I do that, there's a good chance that Ninio is going to get slapped. And at that point, it's kind of a whatever. What am I? I don't know why I even tried. But I do see what I can do. I'll try to dazzle her. Miss. We do have a potion. A bull strength. I refuse to cooperate. The fact that you refuse to cooperate just tells us leaks about your personality than it does anyone else's. Full strength.
The Inheritor, guide my blade.
This will hurt.
It will hurt. Punch it hurt.
Distract them from me.
Okay, can't affect you with vulnerability curse anymore. That or you're already affected by it. May the save. Negates the day's effect and has the damage. Alright. She's not immortal.
I'll rip you apart.
We hit her! We hit her! Holy crap, we hit her! Holy freaking Luya, there is a deity out there. I don't know which one to pray to at the moment. If it bleeds, we can kill it. Drink your potion. Have your vitamins. Murder the hag.
Time to share your treasures.
Stupid concealment. Can't put you to sleep. Ear-piercing scream. That's fine. Holy crap. You do not know how invigorating it is to see something freaking hit this gal. Holy shit. Blinding Ray. misses, but you know what?
Into the fray!
Oh, seeing that concealment reduced! Holy crap! We hit with something! One of the melee combatants hit with something. Unfortunately, Sacred Weapon was not activated at the time, but hey! Actually, is the Axiomatic Strike still effective or whatnot? Oh, whatever. Oh, God. I am pumped. Made her save, but she's taking damage.
They'll beg me to stop.
Oh, my Lord. Damn concealment. That's fine. Okay. I'm trying to think of how the hell to even overcome that, because holy crap.
The Inheritor, guide my blade.
There's quite literally nothing that I have. I don't even have. The problem mostly lies in that I don't have anything that can undo concealment. I don't have dispel magic, that's for sure. And you're plumb out of stuff. That's not just basically straight up fire. One friendly creature within range of touch. Why not?
I'll rip you apart!
Oh, that could have hit. That could have hit. As a standard action within close range. Oh, 5 hit dice, not affected. Got it. Blinding Ray.
The light.
That guidance does help, though. Like, for the times that we can actually hit, it'll be wondrous. What is it? Literally 1 minute or until discharged. Hold the phone a second. Isn't our weapon supposed to be ghost touch? Alright. I know that ghost touch doesn't necessarily mean it's going to hit incorporeal or blurred creatures, but still, it's definitely felt like it should do something in this situation. All right, drink a potion, because it does more than your freaking healing.
Into the fray.
We hit. It was 6 damage, but we hit. What was reduced? All right, because it's. Good or cold iron damage? Shit. Do we even have a cold iron weapon you could use in this situation? That's not Radiance. It's only Radiance. This is why I needed to keep those cold iron glaives. Alright, well. Damage is damage. So I can't complain. Oh. The incessantness of how close we're getting here. 17 rounds of combat.
Beg me to stop.
We're coming up on 17 rounds. This is kind of ridiculous. Is there literally any other spell that you can use? Enlarge person? I mean, that would help, but not exactly sure how much. Because that will make it so as they're easier to hit, too. Also, is it a touch spell? Within close range. So I could make it so as either Sella, I'm probably going to have to re-equip Sella with the Radiance. Within touch. Touch. Yeah. This is one of the things that aren't bad about these spells, but god damn it, they're annoying. In my eyes right now, Ninia, right. Fortitude save negates the effect. Sickened. Sickened is a pretty damn good effect, though. So let's get Ninio. Eh? Right, it's one of those spells. Where it needs to not only hit them,
no glory,
but then they get to make a deck save. This is quite literally the best loop that I could possibly have. She's stupid focused on Sella, who can heal herself, and we have a buttload of potions. And we can whittle her down. And she doesn't seem to give a flying crap. I'm not even gonna bother with Ninio anymore, I think. Oh, damn it, that was so close, Sella.
A calculated risk.
Come on, stab
him. Cover me, alright?
It's actually pretty amazing that she's managed to dodge all the thieves' attacks right about now. Oh. Nat one, nat one. So many nat one. Do we have any? Well, we do have Bone Shaker. Nah, I'd rather not risk that. What I mean to ask is, do I have any Cat's Grace Cat's Grace. Stunning Barrier. Unbreak my heart. No. Because if we had Cat's Grace, then I could give that to Windewog. And Windewog would be in a very good state. Magic weapon primary. Protection from chaos. I might actually give to Sella in this situation. Also restock her potions, because yes. And if she's going to overcome damage reduction, I guess she needs Radiance. So that's going to be her turn. She's going to drink a potion. Swap her weapon. Or am I an idiot? Protection from chaos. Chaotic evil. Nothing seems to have changed for her. That is obnoxious, but okay, I get it. Point blank shot. Have I seriously not had point blank shot on this entire time for her?
This should do it.
Okay. So on the one hand, he did no damage to her. What? -6. +5, minus. Where did the -6 come from? Damage reduction. Should I be sneak attacking? Flanked? And all that fun stuff? Okay, but he did hit, so should have bewildering injury on him on her right now. Additional minus two penalty. Take a penalty for one round. Right? That's how that works, right? The worst part's not even the AC. That's the thing. The worst part's not even the AC. The worst part is her freaking concealment. I have been at this fight for 46 minutes, swinging and whiffing. If she did not have her concealment... then she would most definitely be dead.
Why not both?
Some... 20 minutes ago. Because even if I was only able to hit her on a 20, statistically, I'd still be hitting her.
Let's try this way.
Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby and get ourselves a treat. Do you have any effects that I can use against her? Bonus on saves. Flare. Give her the old razzle dazzle. No. I guess she just decided to completely ignore her when I had clicked the razzle-dazzle. Holy crap, you hit! Oh, she's got 15 hit points left. Come on, Errant. Someone, anyone, hit her.
Distract them from me.
Wait, is it... I think I realized why it was that I had not done the sneak attack because the bullet. Think I do, anyways, because I'm an idiot. That's why. But
oh my god, you hit her. She has 4 hit points left. Someone, for the love of frick.
I am quick saving. I don't care. Worth. Freaking worth. Money. Diamond dust. Story recorded by Tullius Mara from the words of Warren, a peasant from the cool. This is important. Anivia, if you're reading this, know that I'm alive and I'm rallying a troop of survivors to rise to the city's defense. We're going to fight our way to the Defender's Heart Tavern, set up our command there, and hold the line until help arrives, or if the goddess wills it, we'll launch an attack on the Great Garrison. I love you and I trust that we will see each other again in this world, Yorubeth. Oh my gods, I don't know which one in particular... but one of them. That was a test of patience. So is my paladin's consistent need to roll shit when it comes to their freaking. Oh my god. Doing all that. I am so glad that I swapped out from the collapse as much. Oh no, the collapse was still a cold iron. Point is. Did it. Plus one rapier. It's not terrible. Let's give that to you. Wait, did you just lower? No, you didn't. Hold the phone, sir. Why are you doing 1 die 6 plus 1? Finesse wielding means that he should be using... What? What? Okay. So for those that are confused, why I'm confused, this dagger is a finesse weapon, which means that he can use his dexterity modifier for attacks, but for damage it would still be using the strength, if my understanding of it is correct. However, for some reason, trying to equip the rapier, which is also a finesse weapon, while it is magical and it's granting a plus one, he's not getting any bonuses from either stat. Or at least with the dagger, he's at least getting his plus five. Am I missing something about your character? I know you're an eldritch scoundrel, but what about your eldritch scoundrelness makes it so as you specifically use daggers, sir? I mean, Callista, yeah, that's a pretty good one. Not proficient with any armor or shields. Eldritch armor is good. Can't cast spells with somatic components to fail. You're proficient with it. You have sneak attack. Finesse training dagger. Oh. Whenever a rogue makes a successful melee attack with a dagger, she adds her dexterity modifier instead of strength to the damage roll. Okay. So it's something specific for the Eldritch Scoundrel. Because Windowog is also a rogue. But as you can see, Windowog does not have anything that is specific to, hey, don't just use this one type of weapon. So that's his shtick. The rapier is great, and it's magical and whatnot. And the best thing about rapiers is that they have an 18 to 20 critical hit range. So that's essentially a 15% chance to crit. In fact, I used to play with a friend that used rapiers that were keen, so it was essentially a 25% chance to crit. Actually more, I think. But, yeah, we gotta get you some magical daggers then, my friend. If you are gonna be that dagger happy. Oh my god, that was just so much. So much, you guys. I know that I can give Camellia the rapier, but I really don't wanna, because that means investing in Camellia. Suppose I could give it to her for the duration of the visit to the Gwern Manor. You know what? Since we're leaving, might as well. Oh my lord. That was a trip. Now let's get the hell back to the Defender's Hearth. Hearth? Heart? I keep on saying Hearth. Exhausted. Strained. The party heads back to the Defender's Heart. What along the way decides to impede them? A singular shear.
You're irrelevant.
Can we retreat already?
Yum. You know, considering that we also just took out a goddamn Kuzabaduza at this point, this is almost an insult. Almost, I suppose. Hey, there we go. Make it a two for a while, don't you? Or you could just go to sleep. We can end this real fast. Yeah, we can end this real fast. Yeah. I suppose that'd be the great thing about the collapse, too. If we use it against creatures that are downed, the way that coup de grace works is that it automatically crits if you hit them, or when you hit them. And then they need to make a fortitude saving throw or die based on the amount of damage that you do. Which is relatively fine. Excuse you? We're literally within the walls. It's fine. It's fine. Just that final push. That final gathering of loot. What is it you wish to... A Baphomet cleric.
You can handle them, right?
How did you miss? You know what? Someone's getting acid arrowed. Or not. That works too. Thought I put... You know what? It's fine. Yeah, thought so. So what other loser stands against us right about now? Really? Are they even gonna stand out in the dark from the darkness? Oh, there you are.
You should have listened to reason.
Now Aaron's just gonna turn charge happy. Yes. Sorry. I love reading the results of these things because it's like power attack, great, strength, awesome. All that fun stuff. Yeah, might as well loot them all. Their stuff is going to be worth the equivalency of pennies considering the stuff that we just did with the succubi, but... That was literally 50 minutes of me swinging and missing because of concealment, and then when I hit through the concealment... I was missing because I needed to roll like 15 plus depending on the character. The one time Wooljif did hit the succubi, he did literally no damage. That hurts, but at the same time, I did it. How close are we to leveling up? Roughly 2200. Ugh. It's always good to have yourself a nice tavern to come back to every time you're done with a adventure. Hey, Beth. Oh, we can actually do the thing? Oh. Alright. I think we're good at the moment. As much as I do want to read some dialogue of Anivia. Let's see, I think we're done with her too. Right, I definitely want to talk to you, Hylor, about... Hylor? Whatever. About what it is that you would want, what I can do for some of my other characters, because I don't think that Rogue is working for Windowag. I don't think her particular thing of Rogue is working for Windowag. I'm probably going to poke at the idea of changing some of their class stuff before the next episode, of which I'm going to call it an episode here. When we return, I need to assess my situation and see what the hell is going on and what I can do before doing anything with the Grey Garrison. So, thank you everyone so very much for watching. I hope you guys are enjoying this adventure as much as I'm enjoying playing it. And as always, I hope to see you guys in the next video. Take care. Cheers.